गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस चैप्टर 3 अंडरस्टैंडिंग क्वाड्रिलेटरल एक्सरसाइज 3.1। क्वेश्चन नंबर वन है फाइंड द सम ऑफ मेजर ऑफ ऑल इंटीरियर एंगल्स ऑफ अ पॉलीगन विथ साइड 7 एंड 9 साइड्स। आई रिपीट दिस क्वेश्चन अगेन। In this question, questions are tells to us find the sum of measure of all interior angles of a polygon of sides 7 and 9. So student, first here we need to know what is formula to use that we find the sum of all interior angles of any polygon or any sided polygons. Okay. So in previous video we discussed that you know very well n minus 2 into 180 degree, where n represent the number of sides of the polygons. Okay, so here we know that what is that we know that measure of all interior angles of n sided polygons is equal to what? N minus 2 into pi, you can say 180 degree. Square sum of measure of all interior angles n sided polygon is equal to n minus 2 into 180 degree. This clear? In this formula we find the sum of measure of all interior angles of 7 sided polygons and 9 sided polygons. This is clear? Here in interior angles. Okay, now so in first question the number of sides is given. Number of sides is equal to 7. This is given, and here n represent number of sides. So we find the sum of measure of all interior angles of a 7-sided polygons. Okay, so we write here sum of measure of all interior angles. Sum of all interior angle of all interior angles of a 7-sided polygon. This is equal to what? Here you can see n represent number of side of polygon, or the number of side of polygon is 7. Okay, so here you put 7 minus 2 into 180. This is equal to what? If you subtract 2 from 7, then you get 5 into 180 degree. This is equal to 900 degree. student, you can see here the sum of measure of all interior angles of seven sided polygons is 900 degrees. Now the second part of this question is that we need to find the sum of measure of all interior angles of a nine sided polygons. Okay, so let's see. Here you write third second. This is the sum of interior angles of a seven sided polygons is 900 degrees. This is first part of this question. Now we need to solve second part of this question. Okay, so second part. In second part, number of sides is given here. Number of sides is equal to 9. So we need to find sum of all interior angles. Sum of all interior angles. Interior angles of sum of all interior angles of a nine sided polygon. This is equal to what? 9 minus 2 into 180 degrees. Clear? So 9 minus 2 is equal to 7. 7 into 180 degrees. This is clear? And 18, 7 is 126. So you can say 187 1260 degrees. Okay? Sum of all interior angles of a nine sided polygon is 1260 degrees. This is clear. So student, I hope all of you understood this question. Now we are going to discuss next question, question number 2. Question number 2 have, how many sides does a regular polygon have? If each interior angle is 120 degrees, I repeat this question again. How many sides does a regular polygon have if each of its interior angle is 120 degrees? So interior angle is given here 120 degrees. We need to find the number of side of the polygons whose interior angle is 120 degrees. Okay, so how you find interior angle is given here. Okay, so interior angles, this is a regular polygons, and you know very well how you find, which formula we use to find the regular, each angle of regular form polygons. So n minus 2 into 180 upon n. In this formula we find the each angle of any regular polygons where n represent number of side of the regular polygons. Okay, so let's see how to solve this question. Now, so in this question, first we write the each interior angles of n sided polygon is equal to n minus 2 into 180 degrees upon n. So let's see how to solve this question. Question number 2. This is question number 1. In this question, we find the sum of interior angles, sum of all measures of interior angles of seven sided polygons and nine sided polygons is. Okay, so let's see in question number 2. In question number 2, we find what we find here. We find the number of sides of a regular polygon whose interior angle is 120 degree. So we know very well each interior angles of n sided polygon, is n minus 2 into 180 degree upon n. So here you write V. Know that each, we know that, what we know that each interior angles, each interior angle of a regular polygon of n sided regular polygon. This is equal to what? This is equal to, you can say, n minus 2 into 180 degree by n. But in this question, the number of sides, the interior angles, each interior angle is given. Each interior angle is given. Here, what is given? Here given, each interior angle is equal to what? 120 degree. This is given. This is the interior angles of the regular polygons. Okay, but in this formula we find the eight interior angles of the regular polygons. So here n is number of sides. This is clear. So we can write here according to condition we have, what we have? We have here n minus 2 into 180 degree by n is equal to 120. So you can cancel here 0 by 0, 6 to the 12 and 6 to the 18. So you can write here n minus 2 is equal to what? N minus 2 into 3 is equal to 2n. This is clear? Now, so if you open this bracket, you get here 3n minus 6 is equal to 2n. If you simplify this, you get n is equal to what? N is equal to 6. So the number of sides of regular polygon is 6. As you can see, this is a, what is this? This is a regular hexagon. The name of this polygon is a regular hexagon. So number of sides of regular polygons is equal to 6. In this question, this is given that how many sides does a regular polygon have if each of its interior angle is 120 degrees. Interior angle is given, so you need to find the number of sides. So for this, we know this formula, n minus 2 into 180 degree by n. In this formula, we find the interior angles of n sided regular polygons. But here interior angle is given 120 degree. So we need to find the number of sides of this polygons whose interior angle is what? Whose interior angle is 120 degree. Also you can find, so if you equal this formula is equal to 120 degree, then you can find the number of sides of this polygons. This is equal to 6. Okay. Now you can also find the number of sides of this polygons whose interior angle is 120 degree. सो फर्स्ट इन नेक्स्ट फॉर्मूला फर्स्ट वी फाइंड द एक्सटीरियर एंगल्स, एक्सटीरियर एंगल्स ऑफ द पॉलीगन्स। आफ्टर दिस यू कैन डिवाइड 360 डिग्री बाय एक्सटीरियर एंगल्स ऑफ दिस पॉलीगन, देन यू फाइंड द नंबर ऑफ साइड्स। लेट्स सी हाउ वी यूज द सेकेंड फार्मूला टू फाइंड द इंटीरियर नंबर ऑफ साइड ऑफ द रेगुलर पॉलीगन्स, ओके, व्हेन इट्स इंटीरियर एंगल इज गिवन। सो लेट्स सी हाउ कैन वी सॉल्व द सेकेंड वे, अदर वे, द क्वेश्चन नंबर टू। इन दिस क्वेश्चन द इंटीरियर एंगल इज गिवन, इंटीरियर एंगल इज गिवन, सो हियर यू कैन राइट इंटीरियर एंगल इज इक्वल टू वन, इंटीरियर एंगल is equal to 120 degree, okay? Here you can see this is a three select polygon, okay? Like this, so A, B, C, this is a, here, this is a three sided polygons, A, B, C, you can see this is triangles, okay? Now, so angle A, angle B, angle C are interior angles. If you produce this BC, BC at point D, so this angle is the exterior angle, and you can see this straight line. So the value of straight angle is what? The value of straight angle is 180 degree. Okay, so this angle is exterior angle. Clear, clear, and this angle is interior angle. Interior angle. So sum of interior and exterior angle is equal to what? Sum of interior and exterior angle is equal to 180 degree. This is clear? Now, so here we find interior angle. Okay? Here we know that, we can write here. We know that. We know that. Interior sum of interior angle plus and exterior angle is equal to 180 degree. So you can write here interior angle, interior angle plus exterior angle, angle this is equal to 180 degree. Clear? Interior angle plus exterior angle is equal to 180 degree. So interior angle is given here 120 degree plus we write here exterior angle. Exterior angle. Clear? Now this is equal to 180 degree. Or you can write here exterior angle is equal to what? Exterior angle is equal to 120, you can say this becomes 180 minus 120, 180 degree minus 120 degree, this is equal to what? This is equal to 60 degree. Clear? So here you find the exterior angles. Okay, now, so we need to find number of sides. Number of side of regular polygons, okay? Number of side. Number of side of regular polygon. This is equal to what? This is equal to 360 degree by exterior angle. Exterior angle. This is equal to what? 360 degree minus what? 60 degree. So this is equal to what? This is equal to 6. So then you can see here, we find the number of sides of the polygons whose interior angle is 120 degree is 6. Again, so you can see in both way. We find the same value, 6. The number of sides of these polygons, regular polygons is 6. You can see in both way. Now, we are going to discuss next questions. I hope all of you understood these questions. Okay? And now, we are going to discuss next question. Question number 3. In this question, figure is given and we need to find the value of x. So let's see how to find the value of x in the given figures. One figures we discuss here. After this, remaining part of this question you can do yourself. Okay. Students, you have given the sum of interior angles of rectangles is 180 degree, and the sum of interior angles, sum of measure of all interior angles of a triangle of a quadrilateral 360 degree. This is clear now. So one figure is given here like this. Okay, this is a one figure is given here and like this. Okay, and this is given 120 degree. Clear? Now this is the x. This is 50 degree and this is 60 degree. Okay? If you let here A, B, C, D. Clear? So here we need to find the value of x. As you know, the sum of all interior angles of a quadrilaterals is 360 degree. So let's see. You can write here. This is question number 3. Sum of all interior angle, interior angle of quadrilateral. This is equal to 360 degree. So you can see here angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D. This is equal to what? This is equal to 360 degree. Okay. Now, so angle A is 120 degree, angle B x degree, angle C is 50 degree, and angle D is 60 degree. This is equal to what? 360 degree. If you add them, okay, so you get 18 plus 5, 23, 230 degree. This is equal to 360 degree. Or you can write here, x is equal to 360 degree minus 230 degree. Or x is equal to what? X is equal to, you can write 130 degree. This is clear. So student, I hope all of you understood this question. Now, and one more figure is given here. I want to explain this figure because I think this is important. Questions? Let's see. Next question, next part. This is the first part. The first figure of question number 3. Now, we are going to discuss second question, second part of this question number 3. Second part is given like this. This, and like this. Okay? And here, this angle is also given here. This angle is 140 degree. 140 degree. Okay? And after this, x, this value is x degree. This is given 150 degree and this is 70 degree. Clear? So we need to find here the value of x. What is the value of x? How can you find? So students, you can, you know, here this is interior angle, this is exterior angle. The sum of interior angles and exterior angles is equal to 180 degree. So here exterior angle is given 140 degree. So how we find interior angle? If we subtract exterior angle from 180 degree, then you get interior angle. So for this angle, we can solve it. If you subtract 180 degree, because this is straight line, this is straight angle. Straight angles is 180 degree. So straight angle divided two part, interior angles and exterior angles. Exterior angles is given here 140 degree. If you subtract exterior angles from 180 degree, there we find, what you find? This is 40 degree, this is the interior angle. So this is interior angle, 40 degree. Now, so this is the collectors, because it's the four side, four angles, and every collectors sum of interior angles of all collectors are 360 degree. This is clear. Now, so if we add them, then it's equal to 360 degree. So we write here, we know that sum of all interior angle of a collectors is 360 degrees. So here we write x plus 150 degree plus 70 degree plus 40 degree. This is equal to 360 degree. Clear? Now, if you add them, then you get x plus 260 degree is equal to 360 degree. Now, x is equal to what? X is equal to, you can write 360 degree minus 260 degree. This is equal to, x is equal to 100 degree. Clear? X is equal to 100 degree. So then, I hope all of you understood these questions. Now, we are going to discuss next question. Question number 4 है, if the angles of a collectors are in the ratio 5:8:11:12, find the angles. Okay, I repeat this question again. If the angles of a collectors are in the ratio 5:8:11:12, find the angle. So student, here we let the angles of collectors are 5x, 8x, 11x and 12x. And their sum is equal to very well. What is their sum? Their sum is 360 degree. And if we simplify this, then we find the value of x, and after this we find the angles of the collectors 5x. So it means that 5 into x. And then we put the value of x, then we get the angles of the collectors. Let's see how to solve this. Okay, now, so first we will, after this, we solve question number 4. Here, this is question number 4. We can, here given, what is given, given ratio, given. Ratio is equal to 5:8:11:13. This is clear. Now, after this, we let the angles of collectors are, let the angles of quadrilateral, angles of quadrilateral be 5x, 8x, 11x, 13x respectively. Okay, now, so we know that the sum of, as you know, as
we know sum of the angles, all angles of the quadrilaterals. This is equal to 360 degree. If you add them, then you get 36. Then you get 36x is equal to 360 degree, or you can say x is equal to 10 degree. Clear? X is equal to 10 degree. And then you can say the angles are, what is the angles are? The angles of quadrilaterals are 5 into 10, 8 into 10, 11 into 10, and 12 into 10. This is 12, not 13. Okay? 12 into 10. Clear? Now, so right here the angles, the angles of quadrilateral are 50 degree, 80 degree, 110 degree, 120 degree. So student, I hope all of you understood this question. Thank you for watching. Jai.